Good evening. Honorable Dr. Ketan Desai sir, who is like a father figure to me and have been showered enough love and affection by him, and I continue to yearn for more. My immediate past president, Dr. Shantanu Sen. My immediate past president, my elder brother, Dr. Ravi Mankhedkar, who taught IMA how to fight on the streets. All my past presidents and my colleagues, friends, and all the foreign delegates who have given us the opportunity to host them, Professor Dr. Frank Ulrich to Montgomery, Dr. Sonam Dutta, Dr. Chan Nagpal from UK, Ms. Mary Ugrabi, and from Taiwan, Dr. Zhou Fan Gang, and from Myanmar, Professor Khin Pyom Ki, and Dr. Kiao Lin. It's my privilege to stand before you as National President of the Indian Medical Association. My special thanks to Ketan Desai sir again for giving me this opportunity. With a deep sense of humility, I thank you all for reposing your confidence in me to lead the Association of Medical Fraternity at such challenging times. I hope and I assure I will be able to, God gives me that strength that I am able to meet your expectations and face the challenges of a great organization that is the Indian Medical Association. I look forward to blessing of my elders, kind support and cooperation of all of you. As I stand before you, I dedicate my address to my late father. Who taught us all that? I would like to reiterate and stand by the original resolutions of IMA past 91 years to till this date, which says IMA is of looking after the interest of the medical education of the health care. Friends, ladies and gentlemen, I just want to say the sense of dejection and despair which has and is setting in needs to be addressed, and don't worry, we all will together do the needful. Whereas I will be taking forward all the good work done by my predecessors, in the logical conclusion, the following important activities will be taken on by a priority. I have grown up with the belief that I am a family, and we all follow the same, and we see and meet during these conferences where we discuss the issues affecting us. Because for our academic fees, we have our respective specialty organizations, but for us politically to survive, it's IMA. And IMA, whether it is a 5-member branch or a 10-member branch or a 1,000-member branch, each and every member is important. Violence against doctors, healthcare establishments, and clerical establishments. As Desai sir said, the policy is total zero tolerance. We will not tolerate any violence on us. When we step into our medical schools and pass out, and when we are in practice, the only rightful people who can ever hit us or scold us is our parents. Even they don't do so. So what right such people do have to, because it not only affects your dignity, It shatters your confidence. And a father or a mother who is a role model to the children, they are in a dilemma to face their children, that I could not protect myself. So this has to be taken very seriously by all of us. Not only violence on us, our medical equipment, establishments, which we have made with our heart and money, and also our supportive staff, family of healthcare professionals. We need to take care of them also. And to this day, I request and urge, and I want to pass it, that all cases of violence should be registered. Follow it up. Violence Act will come. But if you follow it up locally, you will never fail. We started this in Yamunanagar, Haryana. It has been now so many years. We have a violence bill. But Yamunanagar is an exception where we have taken the cases to their logical conclusion, where our colleagues have not withdrawn cases. The problem arises when we withdraw the cases. It gives the people and the society people a confidence to do that harm to the other people also. So let's shun that attitude. IMA demands creation of safe zones in all healthcare establishments and zero tolerance to violence. We have an act passed in 22 states, but twice we have been missing. And the fact which is very clear is the bureaucracy doesn't want it. Today the same thing starts happening to many of the established pillars of democracy. We will have all the litigation in the world and the acts to protect them. Why not us? Friends, we are one of the most educated class of the society. Nobody is more educated than us. Why we are taking it lying down? This is for IMA leadership, but also for you to introspect. The movement of is this will start only and only when, right from a village doctor to a small town doctor, will start this journey. Last year, when we have launched an education of violence, under the decisive guidance, why everybody across India responded so nicely? Because it is harming us. It is demoralizing us. Whether it is a verbal abuse, physical abuse, or are asking for money. Nobody has given us any subsidy to establish a healthcare establishment. We have done our jobs, made money, rented places, made our own hospitals, taking loans. We have not got any charity. We stepped in where the government should have stepped in long ago. And today also, whatever they might say, we are still getting to 70% of the population. Make them aware. Realize your nuisance value. Speeches will come in good, sir. We all have to think as one. These are issues. And also, when we retire, we give our children establishment, financial security. But what we are doing now? Violence, NMC, it is for us to ponder and seriously think. Health policy of the country, Government of India and National Medical Commission Act, I consider it as a challenge and a fiercest attack on the modern healthcare system, which is the most valid system, which is getting results, giving results. When these four pillars of democracy need us in these care, they come to us. But introducing and corrupting the basic DNA of modern medicine, I've been taught in the same system. I idolize my teachers, I dedicate my teachers whenever I see them. They taught us principles, they taught us ethics. But now that same system is being corrupted through various laws. Why? We are one of the most renowned healthcare establishments. We are meeting very good medical graduates. But today that system, by hiring whether multi-doctors, hiring of faculty to overcome the faculty, and this attitude of having a medical college in every district without the requisite manpower will totally damage us. and our children who are taking up profession. A lot of doctors, children are not becoming doctors. Now the middle level practitioners, which is being envisaged, 3.5 lakh doctors, they are going ahead with it. NMC Act was passed with the health minister, unfortunately he's from our same discipline. His speech in both houses of the parliament were totally at variance. The government was afraid of his repercussions. That is why a bill concerning health issues was brought in as a money bill. I must appreciate the efforts of our future MSN and JDN, the way they led the fight. The students are worried. The education at Nirman Bhavan and AIIMS, we had an army of 3,000 young students. On the roads, they came in metros, came out of the metros, went back again, at only one single command. We were 100 of us, there were 3,000 of us. They are concerned. And as elders, we have to meet their concern. We have to take their agitation from them. Because they are bearing the brunt. What is the need to introduce various other disciplines? If you take in account NMC and the National Education Policy, we might end up being the last DNA of pure DNA medical practitioner doctors. And we will have to be blaming ourselves. These 3.5 lakh doctors, when our children get out of the medical schools, sir, they will be competing for those jobs. Who can sacrifice for, how can we forget the sacrifices which we make to become a doctor? Education, medical education has totally gone haywire. It's become costly, expensive. Now an ordinary family boy cannot, boy or girl cannot aspire. So these things taken into policies, suddenly there is such a human cry about patient care. That allied healthcare professional council, we welcome the formation of council. But why do they want them to be called doctors? Why do they want them to start prescribing medicines? Our routine medicines are even prescribed by our roadside chemist brothers. And our system is being corrupted. Now the proposed amendment to Schedule K Drugs and Cosmetics Act. The Health Ministry is amending Schedule K of drugs to allow various categories of healthcare workers and middle level practitioners to prescribe modern medicine without supervision. The Drugs and Cosmetics Act permits of now only pharmacists and single man clinics doctors to dispense medicine, allowing various categories of healthcare professionals and middle level practitioners who are not qualified enough. If you see my last 3 points and this fourth point, is totally against our medical education. Who of us are young and still practicing? Another 5 years, you will see them. Who is going to own up the complications these ill, untrained doctors are going to create? We. And when a patient comes in a serious condition and he dies in our setup, wallets will be on us. And they will go scot-free. There is no binding of the... We are fighting for binding from the, getting released from consumer goods. They are free from everywhere. Ayushman Bharat. The health GDP over the years has seen a colossal neglect by the successive governments. Suddenly health has become a political issue everywhere to provide health care. Now realizing this, over the past few years, as you might recall, RSBY, 30,000 rupees card. Then came ECHS, CGHS. Now this Ayushman Bharat. They are playing all on our money. And they are renting it out to Ayushman insurance agencies, which in entering into pact with us also, they are squeezing our profits. It has been played, the lines have been played so nicely. The care which was, I come from the state of Haryana, the things and the packages which were free of cost by the government of Haryana before are now becoming chargeable and under Ayushman Bharat. They pay for the same cesarean section which was free of cost. Insurance pattern of healthcare system has been a failure. USA is facing its challenges. It's become expensive. Premiums are increasing. Insurance companies are making money. We are always stuck up with delayed payments. I can say in RSBY, I didn't get my money. I ended up paying the TDS. Even the TDS certificates given by the companies were false. And no action was taken. The package rates are so pathetically low that financially unstable. For a cesarean section, 9,000 rupees, cesarean, pediatrician, anesthetist, medicines, and medicines to take home, and ambulance drop off at home. But when they launch a scheme, there is criticism. By the time 30 to 40% enrolled for Ayushman Bharat. So the movement and stand immediately gets diluted. The leadership says they are unsustainable, but already many of us achieved that. So we need to ponder that also. We want a national medical cadre should be formed so that the protocol of our medical officers, respect of the dignity of our doctors should be addressed. One out of context thing I strongly detest is testing of VIP food by our doctors. Why it should? Why not the Tehsil or the DC test the food? Academic wings of IMA, IMA CGP, AMS and AKNC are academic wings. They are doing excellent work, but there are some overlap of courses. Also, lack of recognition of its courses. I'll make efforts to restructure these courses to the requirement of various wings. Topics will be decided in the coming challenges and the topics which are now, like geriatric medicine and other things. Accordingly, modified and duration of the course and fee will be systematized. An attempt will be made to get the courses recognized as post-diplomas by appropriate bodies. I hope I am successful in that. MSN and JDN, they are our future. And I must assure my young friends, we will take the fight on the streets, in the corridors of power, in the NMC, outside NMC. We will not let it down. I assure you the full support of this house and mine support and the next team, IMA support. Healthcare accreditation, quality of patient care service is important, but making a prerequisite of healthcare accreditation by insurance agencies will be a huge roadblock for rendering healthcare services in small and mid-sized towns and especially hilly, tribal and inaccessible areas, where the requirements and the facilities available to set up a health setup are vastly different from the country. Among the size of a country, must realize you cannot have one uniform road. And all the establishments cannot go back with a retrospective effect. Already, NABH is seeing a huge, huge backlog. For single and couple doctor setup, who has a hospital below and stays above, he is the fittest medical officer, emergency medical officer available to the patient. His child might be suffering from fever, but he will be there to see the patient and tend to the patient. Creating those norms for him is a very big joke on our profession. And now to the burning issue of various issues and clearances required. Fire, ETP, STP, environmental waste management. In everything, there is a penal punishment for us. 2 years ago, we had a scientist from the NGT to address us. So when he spoke of everything, there was a jail term for everything for us. So I just said one thing. I said, sir, when we get up in the morning, the first thing we go and see is the biomedical waste dustbins. Not God or temple. Because any sweeper does anything, we are there. The service provider does anything, we are there. Plus, not to forget, increasing the cost of health care. After biomedical waste has gone, we are normal houses or hostels. No other waste is harmful. But we have been given that benefit. We made certain efforts, Dr. Shantanu led the effort, and definitely we will carry it forward. Awareness, information and communication, we cannot run away from the fact. In the current era of effective communication with patients and relatives, which is the right. Sir, change is important. From telephone we came to mobile, from mobile we came to smartphones. From that attitude of keeping a patient arm's length away, we have to make them sit. Let's introspect on this count and a lot of problems will be solved. We still are one of the most noble professions. When we go out in the markets, we get people who touch our feet and say, Doctor, aapne theek kiya mujhe. But somewhere that fabric of connectivity has got not broken, but severed to a great extent, which now we can improve with effective communication, welcome him with a smile, show empathy and sympathy with the patient and relatives, and own your complications rather than getting rid of the patient. The patient will always understand. And in the hour of crisis, never charge for a complication. This is my suggestion. Baki, everything is taken as it is, whenever it is required. Now, the lack of planning. Planning was very good when it was planned. The healthcare to be provided by the government, the CHCs, PHCs, and civil hospitals. But they didn't keep pace with the changing times. This is where we stepped in. Making a CHC in a village with no proper access to the doctors, not caring of the community, conveyance allowance, or his staying facilities, he's forced to come back to the town. Doctors, sir, are ready to go everywhere. Plus, treat us as first-class citizens and create facilities for our comfort, comfortable stay and our family stay. The schemes, today, I don't know how many of you will acknowledge that. We are seeing a closure of hospitals. Because insurance schemes, payments are coming less, not on time. Who are doing CGHS, ECHS, Ayushman Bharat. So margin of profit is very less, getting less day by day. The running cost with NABH and other things, their cost is increasing. My theme for this year is protect the single and couple doctor setups. They are our heritage. They still are the best friend and relative of many families who share their marriages and deaths with their doctors. And whenever they are, they accept that our doctor has been the best. Not one, three generations are there with the same doctor. In conclusion, I want all my brethren and their family members to be healthy and stress-free. Stress is one known factor. Boss, live a life after it, please. And should take up quality time for the family and find ways and means to be stress-free and attend more IMA meetings. Further, I appeal all my faculty members to remain undisturbed by unwanted rumors spread through social media on activities of IMA or things happening. Such messages demoralize. One message said, it suddenly corroborated so much, and then it ultimately ends in normal people groups and becomes the truth. IMA will all make all possible efforts to reach out and disseminate the messages through our leaders, and we are launching a special membership address details drive. And I would request all the presidents and the state leaders, please go back and start sharing your membership details of your branches and states so that we can update the IMA membership directory to the full list. At the moment, we just have the correct addresses of around 70,000. In the end, I sincerely thank my brother, Dr. Shantanu Sen, Bhabhi Kakali Sen, and my young daughter, Swamini, immediate past National President, Dr. Ravivan Khedkar, and my pillar of strength, Dr. R.V. Ashokan, who has always been a great support, and with Shantanu in the chair, the last year, and with R.V. Ashokan, we, under guidance of great Dr. Ketan sir, we performed nicely as a team, and I hope to continue the same with all the support and dignitaries on the dais and all the colleagues. Now, I expect the similar, all the office bearers of IMA headquarters, schemes and wings, and all the staff of IMA headquarters, my staff family, I enjoyed their full cooperation and expect so from the same. Your one last year active participation, National President-elect, and I expect the similar cooperation from all of you. Last but not the least, I seek my blessings of my mother, my mother-in-law, my aunt, my elder brother, Dr. Sandeep Sharma, his wife, Renu, my three lifelines, Meenakshi, Tanya, and Riya, and all my friends and family from Yamunanagar, Umesh Ji, Nayak Sahab, Raman, Samira, Gil, my best friend, and my IMA family from Yamunanagar, our President Dr. Gheesh Jindal, D.K. Soni, Bharti, and my family from Haryana. Thank you guys. Yamunanagar supported me all throughout, and my IMA Haryana family supported me also. Thank you so much. This is only for Ketan sir. Ketan sir, many of you might not be aware, it was my father's dream to become the National President. Sorry, who is it?